Nepal in Forbes magazine. Ladies and gentlemen, that I have together for Dr. Chaudhary.
For that very generous introduction. Former Minister of Finance, former President of MAN, my friend Rajiv Kaul, who I have the privilege of knowing for more than three decades, not only a very accomplished businessman in India, but also the former President of CII, who's played a significant role in bringing the two private sectors between Nepal and India together. In fact, one of the reasons I'm standing here in the midst of yourself is Rajiv. Visiting delegates of AAMO, we are delighted to be welcoming, I was told, from eight countries representing their respective management experts and through their bodies. Executive Director of MAN and members of Executive Committee of MAN, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much, Monji, for this opportunity to share my thoughts on this important occasion. I want to first of all congratulate AAMO on the occasion of your 7th Annual General Meeting and 2nd Council Meeting. I think it's a tremendous initiative for bringing in the associations which represent the successful managers of the respective countries together to share their experiences and also share the challenges that the world, the managers, the world is facing today. And same times, the opportunities that we are sitting in the midst. When I was asked to come and speak here, I was thinking, what would be an appropriate subject for discussing? The issues of managers in Nepal or what is happening in Asia, which is many of the countries, Malaysia, for instance, has gone to a different level. India is trying to strive to create that bridge between what is happening in the Western world in the wake of the new age technology. The whole world, the whole businesses, the establishments, the way the managers used to think and operate, is beginning to change. Artificial intelligence, for instance, which is the buzzword of today. No matter how much we try to delay the implications of artificial intelligence, but it's a reality. As per a study done by Oxford in 2013, 47% of the jobs in US is at the danger of becoming irrelevant. One McKinsey recently tabled a report which says that 400 to 800 million jobs is going to become automated. There are countries like us who are still trying to grow. I'll give you an example of, you know, some of the industries that we are involved in. Manufacturing industry, fast-moving consumer goods industry, we are still expanding our distribution by appointing distributors and dealers and retailers, whereas that's all becoming irrelevant because of Amazon and Alibaba. Banks, their size is measured or their width and depth in the penetration of the business is measured by how many branches we have or where we've been able to reach out in terms of our branches. Branches are becoming liabilities to the bank because it's all good. The age of branchless banking is taking over. In 1946, when a computer was invented, the size of the computer was 27 tons, I'm told, and 1,800 square foot was the space that it had covered. Today, this one little device is not only controlling your business, your personal life, your social life, your public life, and as with the passage of time, practically everything, from entertainment. Now, in this context, we managers have the challenges of augmenting our organization, our management team, and our future. You cannot disown the legacy on one hand. On the other hand, you cannot survive without embracing the fast-changing technology. You cannot say, okay, fine, times are far when driverless car will hit the roads of Kathmandu. But that's already become a reality somewhere. The implication of a driverless car, somebody told me, and it was scary. We may take a few years because we need to still clean up those wires and, stuff on our roads in Kathmandu, but the thing is, people will stop keeping a car at home, people will stop hiring a driver. Simply a car will take you to the office and then whole day it will do some income generation, taxing around. And in the evening it will drop you home and go somewhere and park itself. I think that's the kind of an ecosystem that the world is thinking about. Obviously, it is a amazing future when you think of it, when you fantasize. Just today, I was looking at a news item where the new flying cab was demonstrated. It was, I think, in Paris, Seoul, or somewhere. Okay, that day is not very far. It's going to be launched in Singapore in 2019, I was told. Dubai had already made the trials. Now, on one hand, we are going to be facing a situation where the way we do business is going to change. Our business models are going to change, as I mentioned. And if we do not change, and if we as leaders do not show that vision to transform our organization or adapt the change, we have the danger of becoming a BlackBerry or a Kodak. Precisely why Kodak went out of business and precisely why BlackBerry went out of business. They could not see, they could not catch, they could not grasp the moment, which is so critical. I think this is the most fundamental question that we as managers are going to face, and now we are going to face. On one hand, we cannot forget, particularly in our part of the world, in Asia, the teachings that we have received from our respective epics, the teachings that we've drawn in from Nepal, for instance, from Bhagavad Gita. Okay? Which on one hand tells you to go for your goal, but on the other hand it tells you also to maintain your compassion and emotions and your concerns for the human responsibilities towards your society, towards your people, and towards your organization. So how do you take your managers, how do you train them, how do you build them without compromising its optimization of the values, because your products can't be, you have to compete at the end of the day. I mean, as much as we can talk about human considerations, you've got to also remain competitive, because all the tariff and non-tariff walls are getting dismantled every day. We have to compete with the factories of the world in countries, particularly smaller countries like Nepal. We freely compete with India and China. We have to compete. We have to preserve our industry. Our industry has to transform from one sector to the other, where we are competitive. I'm sure if we in Nepal have one set of competitive edges, in many of the countries of AAMO, many of the members of the AAMO countries, you have other sets of opportunities and challenges. I thought that what is the right balance? Where do you make the beginning and where do you stop it? In terms of transforming your organization, planning your organization, planning your companies. I mean, it's a huge issue we are going to be facing if 70% of my distribution channel is going to become irrelevant in reaching out to my product from my factory to a consumer's hand. And that's what is happening worldwide. It's going to make sure, for sure, the product very competitive. The 30%, you know, circa cost of distribution is going to completely be eliminated. So in this backdrop, I think you guys are intended, Rajiv. I think every country is at different level of development and progress. In terms of the level of professionalism, level of management cadre that we've been able to build. But the technology is common, let's not forget it. The technology is not going to leave a country, you know, excuse a country by saying, or an enterprise by saying, you come from the third world, you will take time, you still wait for 20 years and I'm still going to be there. It's not going. You have the pressure of augmenting yourself and embrace that technological change without, or sometimes, or let's say with marginal change of the overall ecosystem, the environment, if you want to remain, if you are a transnational player in particular, or you are competing with products and services from other countries, which I think the whole world is today. Unless you want to behave like America, you know, you are pushed in a situation where there is no room for coming up with walls which is going to protect you. It's your product, it's your brand, it's your organization. Organization is going to, the tomorrow's future, tomorrow, this situation, this unique situation is going to create enormous amount of opportunities for tech-savvy people, for the new generation, which is a good news. It's a great news. But it's also going to leave huge amount of people redundant who cannot catch up. I think I would, without, when the masters talk, there is no prologue. I don't need to give more. This is the thought I wanted to share. I think you need to brainstorm. You need to come up with the right solutions. How the managers need to prepare their organization to face this change without compromising, neither in the quality of your product or enterprise, nor compromising on your human values an organization. Because you are sitting with a responsibility as an organization. You know, I mean, in US or in the Western market or in many of the other developed market, cutting job is a very easy phenomenon. But in many of the Asian countries, that's not something which is thinkable. You've got to take them along. A, because of the regulatory environment. B, because of certain part of a responsibility that you as an employer have towards them who've given their lives or who've given their youth to your organization. So please, sir, I wish you all the best and every success to AAMO. And leave these thoughts and look forward to hearing more from you all on how you come up with some meaningful recommendations to your managers and your, and these recommendations will certainly go forward to the different members of the respective management associations. Thank you once again for this opportunity and I wish you a stay a very pleasant one. Enjoy Nepal. This is the best time you can be in Nepal. And to come back. Thank you.